Today we're driving a 2023 Audi S6. I just got this in yesterday. I figured I'd give you guys some first impressions on what this thing is like to drive. First, let's start it up. We'll walk you around it and we'll take it on the road and give you guys some thoughts on what this has been like to live with so far. So we have a 2.9 liter twin turbo V6 with an electric supercharger that's powered by a 48 volt hybrid system. That powertrain, that engine, is mated to an 8-speed automatic. Of course, it's all-wheel drive. It's an Audi. This has some pretty cool options. The Prestige package, the S Sport package with four-wheel steer and a sport exhaust. So yeah, let's walk around this real quick, show you what it looks like on the outside. Oh yeah. This Audi S6 is painted in Aviator gray with a pearl effect. Pretty cool looking color. I like the understated performance feel and look to this S6. It's a pretty big sedan on the road. We get quad exhaust tips in the back, blacked out Audi badge, these massive 21-inch wheels. Today we're on winter tires, a set of Pirelli Sotto Zeros, and 255 35 R21 up front. Gosh, look at these brakes. They are just enormous. Wow, way to fill up a 21-inch wheel with brakes. Good job, Audi. And in the back, same, 255 35 R21s. This S6 has a real presence on the road. It's understated, it looks luxurious and expensive, but it's not garish or shouty. I like the headlight design. Look at this, that's really cool. We'll be doing a night drive in this car too later this week, wrap up some thoughts on it, but I figured I'd show you what it looks like in the daylight. Let's start out in the back here. We've driven a number of Audi S products recently. The SQ7 was fantastic. I loved the S3 that I drove last year. Audi's doing a pretty nice job with this lineup. The sport exhaust on this S6 sounds really nice. Gosh, you even get a compact spare tire back there. That's neat. Massive trunk. Of course, power operated. You can fold down each of these seats individually, which is great. Let's see what the rear legroom is like. I haven't even been back here yet. Rear window shade. There's this interesting kind of carbon fiber-like weave, but it's naked, it's exposed, it's textured. Feels pretty good. We also get a Bang & Olufsen sound system in this S6 as part of the Prestige package. Oh yeah, starting price on this is about $74,000, as tested, 91 grand. And look at these seat belts, the red stitching on the edges. That's pretty cool. Black headliner, tons of room in the back of this S6. This feels good. Alcantara suede in places, contrast red stitching, a very nice interior. All the switchgear, all the buttons, everything in here feels very high quality. And it's relatively simple too. If Mercedes has too many touch screens and BMW is getting a little bit complicated with their new iDrive system, there are a lot of screens in this Audi, but they all have relatively simple functions and constant controls. The icons for the climate control are very easy and large and quick to use and functional. And then everything else is just kind of oriented towards CarPlay and the bare necessities. The digital center gauge cluster is clear, easy to read. You can customize it however you want. And then for everything else, you get a physical button, which is really nice. Slightly larger sunroof up there. Frameless rear view mirror. Yeah, nice interior space. Rear climate control, of course, two USB-C ports. Let's take a look under the hood. This 2.9 liter twin turbo electrically supercharged V6. A lot going on there. Nice. Squeezes in here just fine. Audi's engine bays used to look a little bit more special. We've just got this plastic cover on here now. This takes 0W30 oil, and I assume premium gasoline. premium 91 plus required. All right, let's hop in. We'll show you around a little bit more on the front seat and then we'll take this for a drive. No point dilly-dallying. I like that we get actual door handles here too. No gimmicks, no silly, unnecessary stuff in this S6. Everything in this interior is pretty much the same as what we've seen in a lot of other Audi models. Lots of consistency between models with their interior switchgear, layout, etc. It's a nice place. A little bit of reflective surfaces down here with the gloss black and the aluminum. On a sunny day, you get a lot of glare from the sun, but again, minor complaint there. The gloss black, or the piano black, actually looks really nice in this S6. A few scratches down here, you just kind of have to be careful with this more highly trafficked area, but always keep your microfiber polishing cloth with you. You've got wireless phone charging here and a center console, two more USB-C ports. There's your glove box, and then all of your climate control icons. Audi used to have the nicest climate knobs, and I guess this is okay now too. You get a very satisfying haptic click with each press. Just been leaving that on auto. We get heated seats. I don't believe we get a heated steering wheel in whatever packages this is equipped with. We can change our gauge cluster view. We have a number of different displays. If we go into settings, display and brightness, Audi virtual cockpit, we can change to a performance display. A lot of information there. Dynamic. That's interesting. Honestly, I really like this classic sport display. It's interesting, whenever you change displays, it says, do you really want to change the layout in the virtual cockpit? Warning, driver may become distracted, as if you're not already going through three menus to do that anyway. CarPlay connects wirelessly. No issues with that this week. This infotainment seems to be pretty responsive and quick, except for right there. No complaints with that. It's a nice high quality screen. And again, you get these nice constant icons to the left side so you can quickly access things and navigate around. But honestly, once you kind of set this car up, you can forget about all that. Reverse and 360 cam and a 3D surround cam, which you can scroll around, which is pretty cool. That looks good. All right, let's go for a drive. There we go, get that reverse cam back. Nice visibility all the way around too. See what type of driving position adjustment we have. Mechanically operated steering wheel tilt and telescoping. Very comfortable seats here too. A lot of bolstering. Yeah, looks good. We have a number of different drive modes: comfort, auto, dynamic, and individual. Steering is super light. Like this little bump out in the wheel at the bottom. Very smooth off the line. And this has four-wheel steer as well, so we have a super quick steering ratio. It's a little bit trippy once you get into this car at first, but you can just turn on a dime in this S6. Ooh, yeah. This sport exhaust is actually pretty rowdy. I've driven some Audis recently with a sport exhaust system that was a little bit more subdued, a little bit less sporty, I guess, like in the RS6 wagon, but this delivers. This sounds really good. You can get some pops and burbles on the overrun. Start off, we'll leave this in auto mode, and then we'll switch into dynamic and have a bit more fun around some corners. Awesome bite and response from those massive front brakes. Stop start is seamless, fires up immediately without any starter noise with that mild hybrid system. We're also on air suspension. You can change the ride height, get a little bit more ground clearance if you so choose. All right, we're in dynamic mode. Let's see how this tackles the corner. Remember, we are still on winter tires here. A little bit of body roll setting into this corner. Some nice rotation as you can feel that rear wheel steer bring the car around. Nice. It's quick. I like the sound of this V6. It's very low and guttural and throaty. At lower revs, it kind of sounds like an old air-cooled 911. There's just torque everywhere. Sitting on the highway in dynamic mode, ride is well composed, super comfortable. Cruising at about 1600, 1700 RPM at 75 miles per hour. Easy. Not the most responsive paddle shifters, but I guess they suit the character of this car. A lot of complaining from these winter tires. Steer really just kicks in. You feel it immediately. It is not subtle about getting you around a corner fast. Exhaust is wild. It's quick, there is no doubt about that. Super comfortable car. Love the suspension tuning here, it rides so nice. You can even select an individual mode and choose between a bunch of different settings: drive, suspension, tuning, engine sound, steering weight. Honestly, I've mostly just been driving this around this week in auto. Does a pretty nice job of figuring out what you're doing with the car. All right, let's try out our cruise control here. You can skip 5 mile an hour increments with a double press, that's nice, or a single press with 1 mile an hour changes. Easily change following distance. This car also has a head-up display. I've opted to turn that off. So we're engaging adaptive cruise with lane guidance now. Will it auto lane change? I don't believe so. That's okay. Let's see how it keeps us centered around this corner. It's doing a pretty nice job, prompting me to put my hands back on the wheel. Pretty quiet at speed. Like a lot of German cars, there's a lot of options and features that are priced in extra packages and additional trims, but that's just the way it is. It would be nice if a lot of the driver assistance stuff were standard, but that's pretty much how it is with all the German OEMs. Let's turn off cruise control here. We'll even disable lane keep assist. To turn off lane keeping assist, you just hold this button right here on the turn signal stalk. You'd see long term, in the last 1900 miles, this S6 has averaged 18.1 mpg, and that's probably including a bunch of idling for photo shoots. Probably expect high 20s on the highway on a longer road trip. All right, let's go back into dynamic and let's turn traction control off. Sneak a launch control in here somewhere. 0 to 60 should be around 4 seconds, maybe a little bit over. It's no slouch. That initial launch is so powerful. Don't have quite the sharpness between shifts that we do in some RS models, but that's okay. I'm beginning to appreciate the kind of softness to this S6. There's a little bit of body roll when you set into a corner. The 8-speed automatic isn't as sharp and kind of abusive as some other options in this class from other manufacturers. Again, it's a very comfortable and easy luxury car to live with. Love the steering, it's just light. Not a lot of feedback or feel, but there's enough to kind of satisfy the driver in you. And I think something like this would just make for a fantastic daily. All right, I think we should test out the Bang & Olufsen sound system. Just do a quick test here. We've got a physical volume knob down here to the right. It sounds very nice to my ear. Definitely better than what I've heard from Harman Kardon and BMWs. Oops, guess I should. try to look at audio levels, but that's okay. We'll leave that to maybe the night drive. We'll play around a little bit more with the sound system. Okay, so what are some takeaways from this S6 on first impressions? Really torquey powertrain. I'm so impressed with how much pull there is at low revs. This thing just goes on just a little bit of throttle, under 3,000 RPM, and you're off. This powertrain really utilizes that torque from the electric supercharger, the mild hybrid, the twin turbo. It all just comes together into this really smooth, nice, meaty power delivery. And I think this V6 sounds pretty good too. Again, I appreciate the burbles, the pops. It's got some personality to it, which I've noticed that some other Audi exhausts haven't quite had, and this delivers. It's interesting, it's entertaining, and you know, if you just leave this in comfort mode, it doesn't make all that noise, and it's a little bit more subdued. But yeah, really liking this S6 on first impressions, excited to spend some more time in it. We'll come back with a night drive later this week, so stay tuned for that. But for now, I think that's going to be a wrap. Nice, easy ergonomics. Looks good. Attractive inside and out. Not a whole lot that's disagreeable about this interior, about this exterior. I think this is a pretty well-designed car. And again, it goes for a lot of the Audi lineup. You just kind of have to pick your flavor and body style and price and options, and you kind of just go from there.
Your mobile device is still in the vehicle.
She always says that. All right, guys, that'll be it for this one. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Take care. Audi still has my favorite lock sound, lock chime. Finding this to be a really nice car to drive around town, lower speed around the city. The stop start system, the mild hybrid, is all operating in the background. You barely notice it. You can watch the revs just drop a few miles an hour before you come to a stop, let off the brake, they immediately rise up, and you're off. Ride quality is really nice at low speeds. We're probably getting a little bit better noise, vibration, harshness with these winter tires. I'm sure that helps a little bit. Very easy to drive smoothly. Throttle tuning, throttle modulation is all very well done. Brakes aren't too touchy. You can bring this car down from speed smoothly with passengers in the car. You're not going to be jerking people around. smooth, understated performance and luxury. I think just about sums up the Audi S6.